Now let us turn our attention to the adventitious or added sounds produced in the lung tissue, bronchi or pleura. These are abnormal sounds superimposed on the breath sounds and usually indicate disease. There are three main types of adventitious sounds added to the breath sounds: ronchi, rals and pleural rub. Ronchi or wheezes or dry sounds are commonly heard in patients with bronchial asthma. They are continuous musical sounds heard commonly during expiration. They may also be heard during inspiration or both inspiration and expiration. When the airway is obstructed by spasm, secretions or mucosal edema, the opposing airway walls at points where they are just touching each other vibrate like the reed of a toy trumpet and a musical sound is produced. These ronchi may be high-pitched or low-pitched, inspiratory, expiratory or both, short or long, and single or polyphonic. Listen to the high-pitched expiratory ronchi. Listen to the high-pitched inspiratory ronchi. Listen to the ronchi in both inspiration and expiration. Occasionally, in a patient with severe obstructive lung disease, the wheezing may disappear because he can no longer force enough air with enough force through the narrowed bronchi to produce wheezing. Hence, disappearance of wheezing in such a patient may be a bad sign. Rals or crackles or crepitations are sharp, non-musical, interrupted sounds like the sound produced by opening a Velcro patch. Rals are called moist sounds and have been attributed in the past to the sound of air bubbling through the secretions in the airways. This theory of production of rals, however, holds true only in case of coarse rals produced by secretions in the trachea and large bronchi, as in chronic bronchitis, bronchiectasis or lung abscess, and in patients who cannot cough up their secretions. These coarse rals may be heard during inspiration or expiration, and more commonly at the end of inspiration. They may be altered or displaced by the act of coughing. The fine rals or crackling rals or fine crepitations are very fine and multiple sounds occurring transiently at the end of inspiration and have a crackling quality. They are localized and constant and not displaced by coughing. They are produced by sudden separation of the alveolar walls at the end of inspiration by the air rushing into the deflated areas of the lung. Let us listen to the fine rals or crepitations at the end of inspiration. These fine rals are seen in early pneumonia, early pulmonary tuberculosis, atelectasis or collapse of the lung, pulmonary fibrosis, pulmonary edema, and pulmonary congestion over dependent areas in bedridden patients. Latent or faint rales can be best elicited by asking the patient to cough and listening carefully during the deep inspiration that follows a bout of cough. They are termed as post-tussurales. Pleural rub. Normally, the pleural surfaces move smoothly and noiselessly against each other during respiration. But when the pleura is inflamed, as in acute dry pleurisy, before any inflammatory fluid collects as effusion, the two inflamed and roughened surfaces of the pleura rub against each other and produce a creaking, grating sound termed as pleural rub or friction rub. It is commonly heard over the low axillary region where the movement between the parietal and visceral pleura is maximum. Sometimes it is apical in pulmonary tuberculosis and rarely all over one side of the chest. Listen to the pleural rub, which has a rubbing or creaking quality like the creaking sound of new leather and is of loud intensity and superficial nature, sounding very close to the ear. It is heard in both inspiration and expiration, and if very loud, it may even be palpable. The pleural rub differs from the rales in that it is loud and superficial, it is localized to a small area, it is accentuated by pressing the chest piece firmly on the chest wall and is unaltered by coughing. It is often accompanied by local pain and tenderness. Pleural rub is heard only during the first 1 or 2 days of pleurisy. Once the surfaces are separated by fluid, they no longer produce a rub. Sometimes, extraneous sounds not arising in the chest may be heard and confused with crepitations or pleural rub. For example, in subcutaneous emphysema, crackling sounds may be produced by pressure on the air in the subcutaneous tissues. And in a hairy patient, friction between the chest piece and hair may produce crepitation-like sound. Having learned the various breath sounds in health and disease, and the adventitious or added sounds, that is ronchi, rales and rub, let us turn our attention to the voice sounds, that is vocal resonance. When a person speaks, the voice initiates vibrations which are transmitted along the air passages, lung tissue and chest wall and can be auscultated over the chest wall as voice sounds or vocal resonance. It should be realized that the sound produced in the larynx does not have clear syllables and words, and it is more or less monotonous. As this sound passes through the throat, oral cavity and nasal cavities, which act as resonating chambers, some wavelengths are selectively accentuated, and they are modified by the movements of the tongue, lips and soft palate to produce speech. So over the chest, the voice sounds are heard as weak, muffled, indistinct rumbling sounds, where individual syllables are blurred and indistinguishable. Listen first to normal voice and then to normal vocal resonance.
Ek do tin, ek do tin, ek do tin, ek do tin.
The normal vocal resonance is physiologically louder on the right side than left and louder anteriorly than posteriorly. It is very loud over the suprasternal and interscapular regions, which are close to the air passages, and weak over the mammary, scapular and infrascapular regions. Over the trachea, it is much louder and clearer and is termed as physiological bronchophony. The vocal resonance on the whole is louder in thin-chested individuals, children, and louder in men than women due to lower pitched voice. Now we will see the variations in vocal resonance in diseased lungs. The vocal resonance is increased over areas of consolidation of lung, over a superficial cavity and compensatory emphysema. Also, If a bronchus becomes connected to the chest wall by a tumor or lymph node, the vocal resonance will be increased. Decreased vocal resonance is usually seen in pleural diseases like pleural effusion, pneumothorax, or pleural thickening, in emphysema, and in partial airway obstruction. It may be totally absent in large pleural effusion, pneumothorax, mesioemphysema, acute pulmonary edema, or if the lung tissue is absent, as in diaphragmatic hernia or after lobectomy. Now we will listen to some interesting phenomena related to vocal resonance. Bronchophony. If the spoken voice sounds appear unduly loud, clear, and close to the ear, but individual syllables remain indistinguishable, the condition is referred to as bronchophony. Listen to the bronchophony. It is heard in lung consolidation, in lobar or tuberculous pneumonia, in pleural effusion just above the level of the fluid, and in superficial cavities surrounded by consolidated lung tissue. Listen to normal vocal resonance. And bronchophony. Egophony. Sometimes the vocal resonance displays a peculiar quivering nasal quality, like the bleating of a goat, and is termed as egophony. Listen to the normal vocal resonance and then to egophony. This is due to the damping of lower tones by the fluid and reinforcement of higher tones by compressed lung tissue, and is characteristically seen at the upper border of a pleural effusion just above the upper level of percussional dullness. Sometimes it is seen over synpneumonic pleural effusion or over a cavity half filled with secretions. The vocal resonance may also be elicited by using whispered sound, which is not produced in larynx but in the mouth. Ask the patient to whisper 111 repeatedly and auscultate over the chest. Normally, whispered voice sounds are heard very indistinctly or are not heard over the normal chest wall. If they are heard over the chest wall, it is indicative of patchy consolidation or tuberculous infiltration. But when it is heard so clearly that individual words are clearly distinguishable, as if whispered directly into the ears, the phenomenon is referred to as whispering pectoriloquy. Whispering pectoriloquy is seen in a large cavity communicating with a bronchus, consolidation of lung overlying a patent bronchus, compressed lung tissue at the upper border of pleural effusion, and an obstructing tumor in the bronchus. Revision section for breath sounds. First, listen to the vesicular breath sounds heard over normal lung tissue. Note that they are low-pitched rustling sounds with inspiration longer than expiration and no gap between inspiration and expiration. Now listen to the tracheal breath sounds heard over trachea and note the features of bronchial breath sounds. They are high-pitched blowing sounds with expiration longer than inspiration and a gap between inspiration and expiration. Over the right infraclavicular and interscapular regions, we hear bronchovesicular breath sounds. They have a rustling quality like vesicular sounds but are harsher, expiration is prolonged, and there is no gap between inspiration and expiration. Now listen to vesicular breath sounds with prolonged expiration as heard in bronchial asthma. Cavernous type of bronchial breath sounds heard over a cavity. Note the low pitch of the bronchial sounds. Also note the prolonged expiration and the gap between inspiration and expiration. Tubular type of bronchial breath sounds heard in consolidation. Note the high pitch. Also note the gap between inspiration and expiration and the prolonged expiratory phase. Emphoric type of bronchial breath sounds heard over a large smooth-walled cavity or a communicating hydropneumothorax. Note the low-pitched breath sound with high-pitched echo-like overtones. Also note the gap between inspiration and expiration. Ronchi. Listen to the continuous high-pitched musical sounds heard during expiration. Now note ronchi in both inspiration and expiration. Rals. Note the crackling sounds maximum at the end of inspiration. These are coarse rals. Now listen to fine rals occurring transiently at the end of inspiration. Lastly, listen to the pleural rub in acute dry pleurisy. This is a creaking, grating sound, loud, superficial, and present in both inspiration and expiration. This is the end of the section on breath sounds in the series of cassette clinics by Dr. Ghanashyam Vaidya. In case of any difficulties or suggestions, contact Dr. Ghanashyam Vaidya, Karnataka Health Institute, Ghataprabha, District Belgaum, Karnataka,